up, guys? Mike Wienbach coming at you at a very rainy July afternoon. Stuff you shouldn't do. Believe it or not, there are some exercises that will do more harm than good, even if they're on YouTube. So, you shall rely on me to dispel the myth. Number one, walking with a barbell, walking lunges barbell. That exercise is dangerous because most people don't have the balance and they spend too much time balancing and too little exercising. So in general, when you train, you should eliminate outside stresses. So for instance, if you're curling, sit down. Standing curls, you have a tendency to do this. So with lunges, use dumbbells, okay? With the dumbbell, you can use straps if the weight gets heavy. You don't have to worry about balance. If it's too heavy, you drop it. You can lunge out and don't stand up fully. Or you can simply pick something like a Zottman, a SIF lunge, or stepping in and out without ever worrying about dropping a barbell on your head. So that's great. Next exercise you shouldn't be doing, or most of us, the front squat. So the front squat, most people do not have the flexibility and the balance to hold a weight that they can actually move with their legs, which means they will undertrain their legs. So, if you are in the market for beast mode and a tough exercise, use the solche squat. You can rest the bar, just like so. And now I don't have to worry about rolling down my shoulders. I lock my hands and I focus on pushing from the heels and nothing else. Then there's bent over rows with the barbell. It's another thing where I'm partial toward, and the main reason is the grip. The grip being so will not allow for proper lat activation. If your gym has a trap bar like this one, see, now I can actually flex my lats and I move in a much more natural way. If you don't have this, you can either change gyms or you could use dumbbells, okay? Then, next item on the agenda, upright rows. That probably has killed more rotator cuffs than anything in history. Like, you see people like biting into the bar, nuts. If you want a motion like that, do the V-pull. Slight step out, like so, and then pull the elbows up and out. See, now my shoulders are safe. I'm not pulling any higher than this. Then, this. Don't do front raises, period, period. Don't, not that, don't. You know why? Because every single gym goer in North America is overdeveloped here, from pushing, pulling. Instead, do rear delt raises. Flex the tris, just move out like so. Small motion. None of this, keep it controlled. This will A, give you this beautiful 3D look on the delt, and it will keep you healthy. Big bonus. Then, there seems to be this recent donkey invasion into my gym. People standing. Of course, whenever, today being Wednesday, hump day on the internet, must have a glute development picture in a thong. This will not develop anything. Instead, try the cable lunge. Stepping back, and now you can either lean forward a little bit and work primarily on the glute, or stand up tall, and now you're looking into more of a quad motion. The next one is a bit I'm not saying don't do them, but I'm thinking there are better options. Plus, I only give tips. So the pull-up, while it looks mighty cool, again, most people spend too much time getting up there, using momentum. And you gotta remember, the lats do this. So if you find something that mimics this, you're much better off, right? So I come from here, I turn my hands, and squeeze tight. So if your gym has rotating handles for the pull-up, that could also work. And then, triceps. So the other day, I was at 19th Street Gym, and The Rock was there doing underhanded tricep extensions. Needless to say, within 5 minutes, you couldn't find a cable because everybody's doing that. Now, The Rock has big arms, no doubt. But this is bad because you can't fully activate the trice and your grip is the limiting factor, okay? So instead, be smart about things. First things first. The triceps flex back here. So a short bar or rope, you only go till here, which means you're missing out on this. Then there's the strength curve. So you're walking back. This should be good. Get a nice tight squeeze. The bottom, going into the mid-range, and going to the top. I'm not saying I'm better than The Rock before I get all this hate mail. I'm just saying that this particular size is not all that great. Speaking of arms, the barbell curl is overrated. Yep, there, I said it. So, people curl. First of all, you can only curl till here. And secondly, more importantly, you can't do this, right? So for the biceps, be smart about things. Step out, stretch, walk a little bit more, mid-range, and then you set it up top and you can do the behind the neck, and you curl it all the way to here, because that's how the bicep finishes. Okay? So, there you have it. Stuff that could be optimized. My count.